Welcome, everyone. Welcome and good summer morning to the third episode of the It's All For You Demon podcast. It is June 17th, 2016. Summer is in full swing. It's hotter than hell outside. There's a lot of kiss stuff, things going on this summer. So we thought today would be a great day to sit down and wax the greatest summer kiss. What is great about Kiss in the summertime? What do you like to listen to? What do you like to watch? So this is it. The greatest summer kiss. Enjoy. I'm flying in a 747. I don't know about all of you, but my Kiss hot face reaches its peak right around the end of June, the beginning of July. And I think that's because I associate a lot of my Kiss love to summertime. A lot of my early Kiss experiences, things I got into, things I watched, occurred in the summertime. There was that feeling of, you know, just an amazing life because you weren't in school. School was out for the summer. You didn't have a job, and if you did, it was just an easy part-time job. No commitments, no burden, no things tying you down, just the joy of life. And along with that, you had this great rock and roll band that just offered this great escape from reality into kind of this la-la land of rock and roll fun. So I think that's the main reason I associate a lot of my fun memories of Kiss to summer. And that's why my Kiss hot face peaks in the summer, and all of my Kiss kind of energy and imagination and thoughts and fun boil over in the summer. And so that's why I thought it'd be a good time to get together and discuss a few things about Kiss that are fun and remind you of summer. The first item on my list that reminds me of summer would be the first picture I ever saw of Kiss as a little kid, and it's the 1976 Spirit of 76 poster. Oh, yeah! When I first saw this poster as a kid, I had no idea who Kiss was. I had no idea they were a rock band. It was hanging in my next door neighbor's garage. He had motorcycles and he would always work on them and race them up and down the street. He would race us on our bikes and always let us win, which is kind of cool. He loved like Van Halen and Kiss and AC/DC and bands like that, and he had this poster in his garage. And I remember, I don't even think I realized they were a band. I thought they were scary looking. They kind of looked like they were from a horror movie. And I was so young, I didn't catch the Bicentennial 1776 reference. So the bloody bandage on Peter's head really freaked me out. And I thought, this is like a dangerous thing I shouldn't be looking at. But I couldn't take my eyes off of it. And I go to that memory every time I see that poster. For the longest time in high school, I had this poster on my bedroom door. I still would like to get a copy of it. I lost it over the years. It's just one of those iconic images that take you back. And it always takes me back to that summer as a little kid seeing that poster. Then it also takes me back to when I had it on my doors in high school. You know, those just carefree, fun summer days that Kiss is the perfect band to make your summer soundtrack. Music-wise, summer and Kiss, I would pick two albums. I would pick Alive 2 and Crazy Nights. As a single, I would pick Hold Me, Touch Me from the Paul Stanley solo album. Kiss Alive 2 is the definitive summer soundtrack of Kiss for me. You have
the excitement of Alive packaged with the fun of Bubblegum. Alive 1 was just kind of dark and real. Alive 2 is bubbly, bright, just like a big, big hunk of cotton candy on a summer day. You have great songs on it like Making Love, Love Gun, I Stole Your Love, Beth, of course. But the God of Thunder on side 3, there's no more menacing intro of a Kiss Live song. I mean, even in high school, I air guitared that track more than anything. If I was a little kid in the summer of 1978 listening to that record, oh my gosh, so many living room rock star couch moments would have occurred because of that song alone. Alive 2 more than Alive 1. I like the broader track choices. It also has more of my favorite songs, plus the side 4 of the studio track. Rockin' in the USA, Larger Than Life, Rocket Ride. It just makes you sit back and wonder what it would have been like if Kiss hadn't have done the solo albums and done a real studio record. I think that record would have been like a Love Gun Part 2. Maybe not as good. Obviously 100% as fun, as energetic, and as Chapter 2 of a great summer vibe record. I chose Hold Me, Touch Me as a single choice for summer because that song from the Paul Stanley solo album totally reminds me of an AM radio hit. Hold me, touch me. I can picture my older sister in the 70s listening to that song with her friends and a transistor radio. That song reeks of a song tailor-made for girls. It is kind of cheesy, it is kind of soft, it is kind of lame, but it's got a great hook to it. It's got a great arc in the European version of Phantom of the Park when they play it as Melissa is searching for Sam and she can't find him and the security guards are kicking her out.
And she's all pissy and pouty and, you know, I haven't forgotten about this, I'll be back! You bastard stole my boyfriend! It's such a delicious moment in the movie, and this song works so perfectly with that moment of cheese. And you know it'll be
man, it's just a great soundtrack moment of that movie, and it just brings home that mellow 70s, you have nothing to do except have fun,
hot 70s chicks with transistor radio vibe. Thank you.
I think a reason I would actually choose a Paul Stanley solo album over the other solo albums as a summer record, I always group all of my Kiss loves of records to seasons. All of my friends do, all the geeks at It's All For You, Demon, we all do this. To me, Paul is a more summer record. Peter is kind of a rainy day record. Summer, spring, rainy day. Ace is a winter record for me. Gene is definitely October. And so Paul would be a summer record. You know, you're cruising around with the windows down, blasting It's All Right. Everything's good in the world. Woo! My caveat to Crazy Nights being on the list of the greatest summer Kiss would be Crazy Nights has to be played at night. You can play Crazy Nights during the day, and it is a good record, but it's more effective at night.
Such a cool guitar riff, and then you have the delicious Paul Stanley hook of the Emerald Lagasse taking it up a notch at the end. It is summer glory.
Turn On the Night has one of the greatest Paul Stanley radio hooks in it I've ever heard. Hearing this song prior to even being a Kiss fan and thinking, there's something about this song that's like hooked me in. I thought, that song's got it. That guitarist has got it. That singer's got it. The lyrics, the melody line, everything about that song was sucking me in. And little did I know that would be what I would grow to love about Paul Stanley as a songwriter. That song, I remember just cruising around in high school at night on back roads with the windows down, just jamming that song over and over and over again. Such a great feeling of innocence and youth and joy. It's Kiss's most quote-unquote hair metal record of the 80s. I think they were obviously trying to compete with everyone else, especially with the power ballad Reason to Live, which is also a great song, a great hook. You cannot deny the hook in that song.
Yeah.
make fun of it all you want. That is a beautifully written power ballad. And so it is kind of their Sunset Strip record, if you will. A lot of those Sunset Strip records are better at night. I don't know why. I just associate that kind of quote-unquote hair metal again. I hate that word. That kind of era of music with nighttime. I don't know why. It works for me, and Crazy Nights is definitely a summer night record. He tries to possess her.
Lastly, probably the most important item you can love of Kiss in the summer is the 1978 film classic, Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park.
Man, that movie is summer. Amusement parks basically are Kiss. They are an escape. It's a world you enter. Roller coasters, cotton candy, funnel cakes, rides, games, prizes. It's a summer escape. You actually enter this world, and that's really what Kiss is. Kiss is like an escape from the real world. You get out alive to the record. You open the gatefold. You are in that world with that music playing. You are into those characters. You are into the music. You are into the fire, the explosions, the heat, the joy, the escape. And that's what amusement parks are. So Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park took everything that's great about summer. Amusement parks, fun, rides, everything that's great about movies, science fiction, comic books, adventure, intrigue. Everything that's great about rock and roll, you have this rock and roll band that's larger than life. You bring them all together, and there you have Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park. Probably the worst movie ever made, but for a Kiss fan, I don't think you can beat it. If I was being sent to a desert island and could only take one item, I would have to take Phantom of the Park. It's got everything you want. It's got the band, them talking, them playing, them acting, their comic book aura. Science fiction, it's cheesy, it's fun. It is my greatest summer Kiss
escape. I used to watch it
every summer night in college, and usually around the end of May, beginning of June, it comes out and it sits close to the VCR and DVD player, and I watch it sporadically throughout the summer when it's hot outside and I feel that Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park by the pool vibe in the air. Phantom of the Park goes in, and I enjoy a quick summer escape via the greatest movie ever made.
And there you have it.
Nice and quick, a greatest summer Kiss. There's a lot of Kiss information coming up, or a lot of Kiss events coming up. The Freedom of Rock Tour is starting shortly. I know they're coming to Kansas City here July 20th, which is a little over a month away. That'll be a fun show. It'll be exciting to see what the set list holds. I am kind of worried. I'll just throw this out there. I am kind of worried. Paul Stanley was doing interviews yesterday regarding this tour, and he mentioned, quote-unquote, fans shouldn't be punished for being born in a smaller town than a bigger town, and that sometimes bands only see those Midwest towns when they fly from New York to L.A., justifying why Kiss is playing in smaller venues for this tour. That's the same interviews they gave during Revenge, and historically we know that the reason they scaled down the tour and played smaller venues during Revenge is because they couldn't fill the larger arenas. So I don't know, once this tour is done, what's going to be on the next agenda for Kiss. I used to place my bets that it would actually end this year, but now I'm thinking I can see next year revolving into a casino-type acoustic tour, and Evening with Kiss, and I wouldn't doubt it if they bring everyone back. Ace, Bruce, Tommy, Eric, everyone gets together and they play like a historic set of Kiss. But regardless of that, that's just my own ramblings. I hope you enjoyed the greatest summer of Kiss, my picks, the Spirit of 76 poster, Alive 2, Crazy Nights, and the best summer Kiss you could possibly get, the wonderful movie Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park. Thank you for joining. I hope you have a great summer. Hope to maybe do a Wax Night podcast right before the Kiss show. Maybe get some of the other geeks in here and we'll wax some 80s Kiss. Have a good summer. Take care. Thank you for joining.
Happy.